We're going back to the future. This is the German Touring Car Masters 2000. A full house crowd ready for the racing today here in Oschersleben, Germany, the sixth race weekend in the German Touring Car Masters. Before we get to the racing, we'd like to show you one of the top drivers in the field today. Pedro Lamy is not a man of many words. At first, he's quiet and introverted. Those who know him better know about his laid-back sense of humor. Those who work with him know that he's a team player and that he'll fight for touring car success. He's unquestionably fast, but the amount of top competition in the series makes life difficult for him. His first success this season came at the Nürburgring with 2 fourth-place finishes. His career now spans 18 years. He started with mini bikes at the age of 11. Then it was Formula Ford and Formula Opel. He was one of the top drivers in the German Formula 3 Championship. He qualified for Formula 1 after finishing second in the Formula 3000 Championship. He had a bad accident and a weak car, and he knew the situation wasn't good. In 1998, he was a factory driver for Chrysler and started winning again. He won the GT2 World Championship, and with it, his self-confidence was back. In 1999, he was the Mercedes test driver and developer for the CLR prototype. His contract as a touring car factory driver for Mercedes is the key to his career, which has seen its highs and lows. His performance continues to get better, and he certainly hopes it will do so here in Oschersleben this weekend. 2 races set for this round of the German Touring Car Masters here at Oschersleben on this 2.28-mile circuit, 28 laps per race, 20 cars ready to go for the second time this season on this new circuit in Germany. Here's your starting field. Bernd Schneider for the third time this season on the pole. For the second time, Uwe Alsen's on the outside pole. Manuel Reuter, the third man in the points race. Then Jochen Winkelhock, followed by Timo Scheider, the youngest driver in the field, and another rookie, Peter Dumbreck. Then comes Christian Menzel and Pedro Lamy, who you met a little bit earlier. And then Eric Ellery and Thomas Jaeger. Ellery, a very popular Frenchman, looking for some success this season. He's had a difficult start. So we're ready to go here in Oschersleben, race one in the German Touring Car Masters season. Bernd Schneider, the gray Mercedes on the right. Next to him, the Opel, the black with the red trim on the hood, is Uwe Alsen. The course here can be very treacherous simply because of all the dirt and sand that will come up on the course. The drivers will go off and throw it up. Now let's see what happens. They've got a long straightaway, and then there's a left-right combination. Here we go. That's Schneider on the right, Alsen on the left, Winkelhock and Reuter behind them. It's green. We're underway. And Bernd Schneider gets a great jump. Bernd Schneider has the lead going into the first corner, although Alsen is trying to get outside. He won't make the spot. And it's Schneider who takes the lead. Winkelhock has gone off the course. It goes right through the field. And cars are spinning everywhere. Meanwhile, the main field takes off around the course. Some cars here having problems. There goes the hood of Pedro Lamy. The track is blocked. So they're most likely going to have to bring this race to a stop and do a restart. Another of the cars has gone off. This is just one of those times of day that you just want to say, well, let's see if we can get this going again. We have to wait and see what happened. It looked like Winkelhock may have gotten into the corner a little bit late. Meanwhile, the leading group still coming around at full tilt, but they'll get the sign here shortly. There's Marcel Thiemann, naturally a very happy man. As we look at it now, there goes Winkelhock. He heads off in the gravel, which means he has no more control. He cuts right back in behind Reuter and hits Timo Scheider, and then everybody else backs up. And then it becomes a matter of seeing if they can get by with a minimum of trouble. The question is going to be how many cars were damaged and how many can keep going here out of this 20-car field. The yellow Audis at the back of the pack, able to work their way through. Take another look at it from Pedro Lamy. Here you see the cars coming together. About this time, there goes Winkelhock. The cars spin, Lamy is involved, and there goes the camera. Not only is his car seemingly out, so is the camera in that one. They're stopping the race. They're going to have to restart it. Meanwhile, they're going to have to clear the track. So the field backs up, and they're going to have to do a restart here. The question is, how many are going to be left to run? Take another look at this. Winkelhock probably left his braking a little bit too late and came right across in the chicane, hits Timo Scheider, and then everybody else gets into him. Menzel seems to get by okay. Ellery seems to get by, but then everybody else is bumping from behind, and there goes the hood of Pedro Lamy. This was not the most auspicious way to start the day here. The drivers who are left get out and take a look at their car. There's Bartels trying to see what he can do with his. There is the Thomas Jaeger car. Cars now into the pits. This is the Turner car. There's Klaus Ludwig, who is second in the points. His car's running, but they're going to have to do some work on the hood to get it back and ready for the race, which will have to be restarted. Bartel seems to be happy that the car seems to be all right. They're going to have to push it to see if they can get it back into the pit area so that the crews can go to work on it. There's the Marcel Fesler car. It doesn't look like it's going to make it. In all, there seem to be 8 cars that were involved in the wreck. The question is going to be how many can come back. Marcel Thiemann headed for the pits, hoping that they can do some repair work on his car. Timo Scheider stands by his Opel, which is also in very bad shape. There's another view of it as Winkelhock came back onto the track. This accident involved Scheider, Winkelhock, Dumbreck, Fesler, Thiemann, also Jaeger, Lamy, and Turner. The question is going to be how many of them can get their cars back on. This is the first major collision of this type that has happened this season. Another look at Lamy's car as it loses his hood, which is a dangerous moment here. Klaus Ludwig has brought his Mercedes in. The crew is going to work to see if they can get it repaired to get it out. There's Timo Scheider and Jochen Winkelhock in the red driving suit there, lighting up. He's the man that had the problem and came sailing across the gravel and set off the chain reaction accident. He's had his share of problems this season. He has had a couple of victories, but he's also had more than his share of difficulties. Parts of the car being brought back to see if they can get things fixed and brought up. There is the Winkelhock Opel being driven back to the pit area. Now the crews have to go to work. This is one of those difficult times. You have to see all that dirt and dust that's coming up there. Well, it's all along the outside of the track. And now we go to the restart. 12 cars are out there after the accident. Several cars starting on pit lane. Three, in fact, are starting on pit lane. And Uwe Altsen gets the jump this time, not Schneider. They go through the difficult chicane area into the bending turn and out they come. And Uwe Altsen this time is your leader. Bernd Schneider has dropped back. And it's Reuter running third. And let's see who is running fourth. It's Klaus Ludwig running fourth. Christian Menzel is running fifth. And one of the Audis is right up there in front. One of the Audis, it looks like the Christian Opt Audi, is right up there. For the first time, the Audis are up in the top 10. Stefano Modena is right behind the yellow Audi. Modena, who has done well in qualifying, but just hasn't done that well in the races, in his independent Opel. But there's your leader, Uwe Altsen, the man of many faces this season. Last race weekend at the Nürburgring, after not counting the Lausitzring, which was canceled due to some very, very bad weather, Altsen went off the track 11 times. He did not come well with his car. And look at this, Modena and Menzel. Stefano Modena and Christian Menzel are off. The question is, why? Who did what to whom? What a difficult day. What an expensive day. There's the Menzel car. They're going to try to hope that he can get back to the pit area to get it repaired. Menzel goes into the corner. Nobody touched him. Nobody touched him, and he came around, and that's when he hit Modena. So Stefano Modena couldn't do anything about it. The problems that have happened here during the practice sessions and the rest of the practice and test times are that the track gets all kinds of particles, and if you get outside of the racing groove at all, the car has a tendency to take off and leave the track. Right now, your one and two are battling for the lead. Uwe Altsen and Bernd Schneider, Opel against Mercedes. Schneider, by far, the most successful driver this season. He has had an unbelievable season so far, and he just continues to roll. Schneider has five victories, and Michel Bartel's car has lost its rear window. It's still hooked on, but it's hanging off the back, and that will upset the aerodynamics. Altsen, on the other hand, has just had a miserable season. We'll talk about that in a moment. Here is Jochen Winkelhock. He's having problems with the car. They took it into the pits to fix it, but it is not functioning the way he would like it. He's kind of wobbling all over the place. Back up front, Uwe Altsen and Bernd Schneider running nose to tail here in Oschersleben. It's actually the sixth race weekend in the series. The Lausitzring a couple of weeks ago was canceled because of some terrible rains. There was no chance to race. And Winkelhock has spun. After the collision in the first corner, they've not been able to repair the car. But Uwe Altsen is running very, very smoothly. And this is a man on a mission. Altsen has had more did-not-finishes this season than he's had in most any time in his career. He just could not find a way to become one with this car. And one of the problems he has had is a problem that Bernd Schneider, who's right there on your screen, hasn't had, and that's the tires. We'll get to that in a minute. There's the Opel of Winkelhock. They're working on it, trying to see if they can get it ready. Altsen has been going all over the courses. He's been on and off most every course. And they say the secret to the fact that Bernd Schneider, who's right behind him, why he's so fast, why he's so dominant with five victories this season, and he has six fastest laps this season, is the fact that he has figured out the tires. You see, these are tires that everybody has to use the same one. And Dunlop has come up with the tires that everyone has to use, one set of tires. And it seems that Bernd Schneider is the man that's figured out how to get the most out of the tires and his car, the Mercedes. Here he comes up. Can he get by Altsen? Not quite. These are two veterans of touring car racing. They came from different backgrounds. Schneider, the formula route. Uwe Alsen came the touring car and manufacturing type championship series route. He really didn't do the formula racing. He's been in hardtops all his career. He knows how to make the car as wide as he possibly can, meaning that it makes it very hard for someone to get by him. Now, passing is very difficult here at Oschersleben, particularly as we said about the sand on the in and outside of the fast track. But it's also, there is a chance to do some slipstreaming down the long straightaway where they get to about 174 miles an hour, which comes right in front of pit lane. They can slipstream there and make a pass. The question is going to be, is the course dirty? Is it clean? Do they want to take the chance? Because if they go into the first corner and they hit the gravel, then things aren't going to go well. There you see Klaus Ludwig, the oldest driver in the field at 50 years of age, moving up on the youngest driver in the field, Timo Scheider. Scheider has certainly proved to be very competitive this season. He has everyone talking about his great success. He's been very, very consistent. He's ninth in the points, but he's got probably one of the greatest touring car drivers in German history right behind him. And Klaus, who came out of retirement to go into touring cars once again this season, has already picked up two victories this season. He qualified poorly here at Oschersleben back in 14th. But when eight cars crash in front of you, you all of a sudden move up, and that's where he is now. He's back in the top 10. He's running eighth, trying to move up on seventh. That's Michel Bartels ahead of him in sixth position. Here comes Ludwig on the inside, keeping the pressure on the young driver, 21 years old, first time in touring cars, coming out of Formula Racing. A great crowd of over 50,000 for the weekend on hand watching the racing here in Oschersleben. Second time these cars have appeared here this season. Ludwig is not giving Timo Schneider any room. Schneider has Ludwig's car full in his rearview mirror. He doesn't see anything else but that black Mercedes. And he wants to get by Michel Bartels. And Bartels is also driving now with no rear window. It flew out earlier. The battle for sixth, seventh, and eighth position. And in fifth place, look at this. Aiello. Laurent Aiello in the Audi is running fifth. They have not finished in the points all season, this Audi crew. They are totally an independent team. They are not factory supported. They have had to battle all year long in order to get up into the points and gain some respectability. And look at this. Aiello is running fifth. He had surprised everyone in the second practice session as he had the second fastest time. And now look at this. He's running up in fifth position. Naturally, you can thank the crash in the beginning. It took a lot of competition out of the way. But on the other hand, to run fifth and be this far up, that's a great performance for Aiello and for Audi. Michel Bartels, looking for his first success in this new version of the German Touring Car Masters. Formerly, it was called the German Touring Car Championship. Number of years, very, very successful series. It went international for a year, and then it finally shut down. They went to Super Touring Cars in Germany, lasted for a couple of years, but didn't enjoy the same success. And this year, the German Touring Cars, in this version, are back again. You can see Aiello in that yellow Audi. He knows he's got to be happy. Bernd Schneider has a little bit of breathing room now. As you're riding with Bernd Schneider behind Uwe Alsen. But Schneider pulls up on him. Now, this is that long straightaway we talked about. You could do slipstreaming here, but the question is, do you want to take the chance? Alsen really is no competition for Schneider in the points race, who's way out in front. He has a 42-point margin over Ludwig, 51 over Reuter. Alsen is way down the list. In fact, he's in 13th. So Schneider, if he stays in second place and keeps the rest of the competition behind him or they fall out, will gain no matter what happens. But those who know Bernd Schneider know that he's going to try to win. 20 points for a victory is 5 more than 15 for second and a little bit more cushion in the Drivers' Championship. He has said many times his goal this season is to become the first German Touring Car Masters champion. Right now, nothing is going to stop him. Into a very tight chicane, as you can see, they use the curbs abundantly there. It's almost as if it were straight. Back straightaway now, they'll come up a hill, they'll go into a longer chicane, which starts to set them up to return to the front straightaway. Here's the long chicane. There's a short chute, then a right-hander. A short chute, a right-hander, then they're on the long straightaway. And Schneider is not letting off. But Alsen is also a veteran of touring car racing, and it most likely shouldn't faze him. Good look at the long front straightaway here in Oschersleben, up to about 174 miles an hour. Then it's down for the left-hand, right-hand combination, and then a sweeping 180, which brings them back into the infield section of the course. If you're sitting in certain areas of this track, you can see almost 70% of the racing surface, which is great for a road circuit. The question is going to be, how long is Schneider really going to push, or will he settle in and take second place and the 15 points to go with it? Alsen with even more breathing room in front of Schneider. Meanwhile, the battle continues back for 6th, 7th, and 8th position. Ludwig has not been able to get by Timo Schneider, but he has stayed right on his back bumper. And Schneider, to his credit, is staying right on the back bumper of Michel Bartels. And whatever is streaming out of the back is what's left of the rear wind window that he lost earlier in the race. So these three have been battling after about the third or fourth lap and has not stopped. And there's the man who has to be nervous, has to be smiling, Laurent Yellow in that yellow Audi, running in fifth position. Remarkable. In fact, the Audis are up there in ninth and tenth position also. This will be by far their best day in this whole season. Their best finish was an 11th place finish earlier this season. And here comes Ludwig. He gets by Timo Schneider. Either Schneider let him by or got a little bit too wide, but you don't give Klaus Ludwig any room. If you do, he takes advantage, and he has here. So Ludwig, who is running second in the points, needs to pull up on his Mercedes colleague. They're not running for the same teams. If he wants to stay in the hunt for the championship. And Laurent Aiello, the former German super touring car champion, continues to hold on to his fifth place in that bright yellow Audi. Most of the time, the Audis have had to settle for 15th, 16th, 17th positions. They've started back in the grid. They've had one mountain to climb to get that car competitive, and it looks like they've started to come that direction. And Laurent Aiello certainly is an experienced driver, having competed in touring cars, Formula cars. He's also at Le Mans. In fact, that was why he didn't run here the first time this season. He and Christian Abt, who else is the owner of the Abt Racing, were at Le Mans Racing this year. Uwe Alsen with breathing room and just a couple of laps to go. The race had been scheduled for 28 laps, but due to that crash and the time it took to clear the track in the opening moments, they've cut it back down to 25. And it looks like the Bernd Schneider is going to settle in for second place, conserve the car for the second race. Alsen will be making up for what's been a terrible season for him. He just has had miserable luck this season. He qualified fifth in the first race of the season and came up with two did-not-finishes. He qualified 12th here at Oschersleben in the first race of the season, didn't finish the first race, came in ninth in the second race. Alsen at the Norris Ring qualified 12th, finished 8th and 6th. And then the bad luck hit again as he continues to lead here in his black with red trim opal. At the Sachsenring, Alsen qualified 5th but had two did-not-finishes. He qualified 2nd at the Nürburgring and finished 10th and 13th after all those trips into the grass. But here at Oschersleben, he qualified 2nd and now has a chance to win with just a short distance to go. He puts his foot down the long straightaway. Obviously, Bernschneider is settling in for second place. He can hope that something may happen to Alston's car, but there's nothing. It doesn't look like Alston's going to make any mistakes here. And here comes Klaus Ludwig. Ludwig is pushing Michael Bartels for sixth position. Can he get by him? Ludwig is not fooling around. He wants space here. He wants to get by. But nobody's going to touch Laurent Aiello as he goes by. Can Ludwig get by Michael Bartels and pick up some more needed points to stay within at least some sort of striking distance of Bernschneider in the Drivers' Championship? Here he comes inside, can't do it. Look at that, Eric Ellery running in fourth position. Good drive for the Frenchman. Reuter, who is third in the points race, running up right behind Bernschneider, so he will only lose a few points if he can't get by him. It's Ludwig that needs to move up another position to gain some more points. The question is Bartels going to let him by? This is not an easy pace to pass. Here comes Ludwig on the inside, Bartels on the outside, and finally, it looks like Ludwig got by him. Uwe Alsen continues to rule, headed for his first victory of the season in the German Touring Car Masters. It'll be a great day for the Holzer team. They've known that Uwe Alsen can drive. He's won in all types of racing, but this season he just was having a terrible time trying to get that car. And here he comes. He takes the checkered flag, and Uwe Alsen wins his first race of the season, the first race of the day, here in Oschersleben in the German Touring Car Masters. Manuel Reuter comes in third, so he's only going to lose a couple of points here in the championship. And, of course, a very happy team from Opel. First and third. There it is. Eric Ellery, fourth in an Opel. Laurent Aiello brought the Audi in fifth. What a great day for him. Ludwig did take over sixth. Then comes Bartels and Scheider. James Thompson, the new man in the Audi team, taking a respectable ninth. Look at this. Christian Abt in tenth. They both picked up their first points of the season. And the celebrations for the Opel crew. Günter Holzer, the man in the middle, has to be a very happy man. The second race of the day here in Oschersleben, let's take a look at Michael Bartels, one of the top Opel drivers. He doesn't compromise, and he doesn't take things half-heartedly. Michael Bartels dedicates his life to his job. His professional approach and desire to work for the team marks this 32-year-old's career. Sometimes it's his enthusiasm that holds him back. He has a strong will to win, and this is what drives him. Michael Bartels has learned to fight for success, and he doesn't let setbacks get him down. Formula One was always his goal. It started with Formula Ford and then go-karts. Formula 3000 was Bartels' stepping stone into Formula One. But success in Formula One didn't materialize. Four times he tried with an uncompetitive Lotus Jet. Formula One seemed to be out of the picture. Touring cars gave him a new chance. There was Nissan in the Super Touring Cars, and there was Alfa in the German Touring Car Championship. Victory came in Diepholz in 1995, and then there was a year for Opel, and then in 1998 for Zach Speed in the GT World Championship. He's now working with the Phoenix team. His win in the 24 hours of Nürburgring on the long course and a promising position in the German Touring Car Masters shows that he has a great future ahead. So we're ready to go. Second race of the day here in Oschersleben in the German Touring Car Masters. After the first race with the points, and as you get another look at this 2.28 circuit, 28 laps scheduled to go. Bernd Schneider now has 161 points. Klaus Ludwig has 110, still in second place, but has dropped back 51 points. Manuel Reuter has fallen further back to 107 points. He is 54 points behind. Cars still being worked on, hoping that they can get them out for the start of this second race of the day here in Oschersleben. That's the Thomas Jaeger car that you were looking at here. Here's how they line up. Uwe Alsen is on the pole. Bernd Schneider is next to them. They drove nose to tail in the first race. Let's see what happens here in the second event. Manuel Reuter needs to see what he can do to get ahead of Schneider if he wants to catch up in points. Starts third. Eric Ellery is fourth. And Laurent Aiello with the best finish yet for Audi in fifth. Then Klaus Ludwig, who battled all the way back from 14th, is next to him. The Irmscher crew working on Christian Menzel's car as the field rolls around, getting ready for the start of the second event of the day. Schneider is on the left. Uwe Alsen is on the right. Reuters gets a great start, but Alsen gets even a better one. Look at the jump that he got on Schneider. And Manuel Reuter is also going to get by Bernd Schneider. Into the corner that caused so much trouble in the first race. Everyone seems to be getting through just fine. Alec Ellery still sitting back there in fourth position. That's where he finished the first race, but the first two cars are Opels, then a Mercedes, an Opel. Haven't had that in quite a while. Christian Menzel gets back out onto the course without losing a lap, he hopes. Reuter in front of Schneider. There is Eric Ellery running fourth. But Alsen is putting some distance between himself and the rest of the field. Ludwig, the black Mercedes with the red mirrors, running back in sixth position. So Ludwig also another of those who has to move up. Bernd Schneider, you get a look at the start. As Manuel Reuter got a great jump, pulls in front, leaves his braking to the last moment, gets through the corner, and settles into second place. This course is not easy to pass on. These cars, the top cars in particular, all running very, very equal. And there goes Klaus Ludwig once again behind Michel Bartels. He got by him at the last moment, but then Bartels got a better start here. So Bartels is running in fifth, Ludwig is running in sixth, and Timo Scheider is running in seventh. Scheider had been right in front of Ludwig in the last race, and now it's Scheider who's got to try to get by Ludwig. And that's a job for the 21-year-old rookie. The Audis have fallen back here at the start. In fact, Laurent Aiello has fallen way back. He is not in the top five where he finished. You're getting a look at Klaus Ludwig, 50 years old. He'll turn 51 before the next race weekend. Through that tight chicane that everybody just basically straightens out. And Uwe Alsen in the Opel, again in front. Manuel Reuter in second, ahead of the man that's in front of the points race. And Laurent Aiello has fallen way back. He's at the end of the field. Something's wrong with that Audi. The rest of the Audis seem to be doing extremely well. And here comes Jochen Winkelhock on the inside. Oh! And he bumped Nissen. And Christian Abt, the man that owns Nissen's car, got the best view of it. He was right behind it. So one of the Audis off the course. Nissen had finished 11th in the first race. You're riding with Christian Abt now. Here's another look at it. Winkelhock on the inside. Well, Winkelhock certainly was one of the guilty parties on that one. Christian Opp gets a good look at it from behind here, as you can see it. Nissen had the line, and Winkelhock didn't give him the room. You get a good look at it from the car of Christian Opt. There's the battle for second and third position. Manuel Reuter and Bernd Schneider. And the Irmscher crew is pushing the Christian Menzel car back into the garage. He had the spin and collision with Stefano Modena in the first race, and the car just isn't up to the second race at all here. You get a good look at how Ludwig got by Bartels. Bartels came back and bumped him and said hello, but Ludwig got by him. So the touring car champion of years past stays in the competition. He's in the hunt, and he's only two cars behind the man that leads the points. He needs to get by him to gain some ground. Reuter got by Bernd Schneider, who you're riding with right now here at Oschersleben. This is the infield course. You go into a very tight 180. Then you come out of this one, it's a straightaway, and you get bent, ready, set up for the two left-hand bends. It's a little tricky going into this next section. Here's the left-hander, then there's another left-hand bend. And then there's the setup here for the 180. You get a great view of it as they straighten out then and head toward that very tight chicane right there. They straighten that chicane out. And Christian Opt has gone off. Christian Opt, who is running up in the top 10, has gone off. So two of the Audis have gone off. Well, we got to look at inside the car. It doesn't look like he had any help from anybody. At least it can be seen from these shots. There it is. No view yet as to what happened. But Bernd Schneider is not giving up on Manuel Reuter. Reuter is also a very experienced driver who now makes his home in Austria. The German driver is a touring car champion. He's driven all types of cars, Le Mans. He's had all types of competition. Bernd Schneider just wants to make sure Reuter knows he's right there. Meanwhile, look at Uwe Ahlsson pick up a great lead here. He really has some breathing room. Schneider's car is tough, but right now he can't get by. This is the difficult work of cleaning out the gravel from the cars that go into it. Can mess a car up very quickly. Bernd Schneider behind Manuel Reuter is going to go inside. This for second place. He took it. It's the best place to pass on the circuit if you can't do a slipstream here. And so Bernd Schneider has now moved into second place. He has put the third man in the points race behind him. Uwe Ahlsson is no contender for the championship this season after his miserable showings in the beginning of the year. He just had a difficult time. For him, it's now a matter of pride and also to gain points for Opel. Klaus Ludwig, whoa, is he pressuring Ellery? Bernd Schneider, we take another look at it, goes inside. No question, he had the room, he had the space. Reuter had to let him by. And now Reuter has to deal with one of his own teammates, Eric Ellery. But Ellery has to keep Ludwig back. There comes a little bit of team play here because Reuter needs to stay as close to Bernd Schneider as he possibly can, because Reuter does not want to lose much more ground in the championship. Ellery has also had his share of problems this year. He's 10th in the points, at least coming into the weekend. And he's pretty much out of the championship picture. Three drivers are really in it 100%. That's Schneider, Ludwig, and Reuter. Fesler went out of the first race today. That pretty much takes him out of the championship. He was 4th in the points coming into this race weekend. And look at Bernd Schneider gain on Uwe Ahlsson. Schneider just continues to roll here. Whoa, Winkelhock. And that's going to cost him, I would think. It was Fesler going off, and Winkelhock probably was the man that helped him do it. And that's the second time this race. That will probably cost him a stop and go. Or it could, anyway. And Bernd Schneider has made up the distance in a very short period of time. He was 3 seconds and more behind, and now he's just on the back bumper. In a way that has to be sort of depressing for Uwe Olsen. On the other hand, Olsen knows he held him off in the first race, and he has to see what he can do here. Schneider also knows if he sits here and keeps Reuter behind him, and Reuter is way behind him, he picks up more points in the championship. So now it's a question of how hard does Bernd Schneider want to push? And there's Günter Holzer, the man that takes care of the Olsen car. It's nerves time for everybody. Bartels running sixth. There is Jochen Winkelhock. He'd come in for a stop-and-go penalty, but now they're going to have to see what's wrong with the car. They've got to see what they can do with it. He had come in for the 10-second penalty, but that's gone. Now it's a matter of what can they do to the car. And he's basically getting across to somewhere the car is not handling properly throughout the entire course. We can't quite make it all out here. But he's not a happy camper, that's for sure. The fans have got a battle to watch for first and second. We haven't seen this kind of battle all season long. And here comes Bernd Schneider, can't get inside of Uwe Olsen. They just have to remember to stay in the lane, the racing lane. Once you get outside, you get into that gravel dirt, which is thrown up on the course. See that dirt fly? It comes out on the course. You can see the dirt all over. It becomes the so-called marbles, and the cars have a tendency to spin, and there goes Uwe Olsen. That seems to have been a driver error. The car is running smoothly. Uwe made a mistake, and he probably got out into that loose stuff and has dropped all the way back to fifth position. Oh, what a disappointment for him. And oh, what a break for Bernd Schneider. Uwe Olsen into the corner. Schneider had actually backed off. Uwe evidently got out of the line just a little bit. He lost concentration, and he also lost the car. Bernd Schneider gets by on a driving error, and now can kind of coast home. What an unbelievable point for Bernd Schneider. When you're driving well, you're driving fast, the luck also seems to come your way. Wow. Klaus Ludwig running in third position now, it looks like he is. Manuel Reuter is second. There's your third place car. Klaus Ludwig. Uwe Olsen is running in fourth. And Bernd Schneider has a big lead. And we're at the halfway point of the race. Timo Schneider continues to stay up in the sixth position, and another Audi has gone out. Oh, what a terrible time for the Audi crew after the great first race. Thompson, he goes off, comes back on the course, seems to have gotten a hold of the car. He doesn't have it, goes straight off the course into the concrete wall. Well, after all the great success in the first race, it seems like the second race is a disaster for the Abt Audi team. These folks have had an uphill battle all season long, but at least they saw some light at the end of the tunnel in that first race today. Laurent Aiello coming in fifth. The battle you're watching right now is Michel Bartels and Peter Dumbreck. And Bernd Schneider has gone off the course. Bernd Schneider got off the course but came on just in front of the second place car, Manuel Reuter. Well, that certainly made things tight. Schneider had picked up a nice lead after Uwe Olsen spun. Now he's evidently gone off the course, and Reuter is right up on his back bumper. It looked like Schneider, all he had to do was to bring this one home. But now it's turned into a tight race here. Manuel Reuter, the man running second, and Schneider went off, lost it, got in the dirt, got off, crossed the track, got on the grass, stayed out of the gravel, lucky for him, comes back on the course without slowing down, stays in front of Manuel Reuter and holds onto his lead, and look at this, he's already started to stretch it again. Bernd Schneider, the man that everybody wonders how he's going to lose, he has become so strong, it's unbelievable. He took the last two races at the Nürburgring, finished second in the first race of the days here at Oschersleben in the German Touring Car Masters, and now is looking for his sixth victory this season. Of those six, three have come in the second race. Jochen Winkelhock had won the first race at the Nürburgring, and then Schneider came back when Winkelhock made his pit stop error, and Schneider went on. And Timo Scheider spins into the dirt, and boy, is that going to mess up the track. There'll be dust and dirt everywhere on that one. Michel Bartels followed by Peter Dumbreck. Dumbreck involved in the accident in the first race of the day. It was his first, did not finish, actually did not start because they restarted the race, and so he didn't pick up any points. He is a very consistent Scottish driver who's done well this season. Went off the course there. That throws up more dirt for everybody behind him. You see it throws up a huge dust cloud, which impairs the vision, but it also throws all more dirt on the track, which makes the grip that much less. Dumbreck is not letting Michel Bartels breathe here at all. Peter Dumbreck, Michel Bartels, running in fifth and sixth position. And we're in the last lap. The field pretty much settled down except for these two right here. Schneider is out in front. Reuter is second. Ludwig is third. Olsen is fourth. But here comes Bartels and Peter Dumbreck. Dumbreck staying right in the back of Michel Bartels, who should be used to this after today. He's had everybody pushing him on the bumpers. Dumbreck went way off with one last chance to try to make up ground, and instead of that, he's lost some. Meanwhile, Bernd Schneider continues to roll. When Uwe Olsen spun, the race belonged to Bernd Schneider. And Schneider now looking for his sixth victory this season. He had the fastest lap in the first race. He has the fastest lap here in the second race. So he now has, in the 12 races running, he has eight of the fastest laps. What an amazing performance. 12 races, he has six victories. And only once was he out of the top five. It's a tremendous performance. And nobody's able to match him so far. He seems to be in a class for himself this season. And here he comes, headed for the checkered flag. Bernd Schneider wins the second race of the day here in Oschersleben. A happy Mercedes crew also greet Klaus Ludwig, who finishes third. Uwe Olsen is fourth. Bartels, and then comes Peter Dumbreck. So the competition in the points race finished right up there with him, but he finished ahead of them and has picked up more in the points race. And the fans here at Oschersleben certainly got a great race weekend for themselves. Unofficially, if you look at the points, Bernd Schneider should have now about 181 points. Ludwig and Manuel Reuter at 122. So you can see that he has a 59-point lead. 20 points per win. There are 80 points remaining this season. There's your top eight. The best Audi, Laurent Aiello, coming in 11th. Crowd starts to head home as Bernd Schneider comes up to the podium. Bernd Schneider now well on his way to the German Touring Car Masters Championship. Klaus Ludwig and Manuel Reuter. And there you see what we say. Schneider, 181. Ludwig and Reuter, 122. Everybody else is pretty much out of it with 59 points remaining, with actually, 80 points remaining in the season. That's the racing today here in Oschersleben. The next stop on the tour will be the historic Nürburgring. Hope to see you then.